And the recording is back on. Big Silver, ahead to the final chapter. Send into the heart of Eden Hall. Yep, Orphan's Cradle.
Where's the cavalry?
If they made it this far, we'll see him soon enough.
Whoa, yep. Like that.
Seeth. Here we go.
Orphan's Cradle, the Mason's Throne.
This is it. A lot of dreams died to get us here, and we can't let it be for nothing.
You said it. It's not just our future we're fighting for.
We'll do it for everyone. Thassi rule ends here.
Dysley, we're coming for you!
Cradle, dimension created by the foul sea Eden. Cradle will fall. Sell shrouds and libroscopes. But not the ether salves. Those are, yeah, you use those to get TP back, and those are incredibly rare. You either have to find them in treasure chests or dismantle certain rare pieces of gear. Yeah. lots and lots and lots of sacrifices. Get veil and it took them out and kept putting glow on us that kept giving them our haste, but kept having to reapply the haste. And you got lightning back to green. Death on simply with a bunch of damage. Well, pretty much all of Chapter 12 is revisible later. Most of this chapter isn't. There are definitely some areas I can come back to, but not a whole lot.
Take this! Let's go!
this like the group that's actually like the best one right here? Really, I think this is supposed to be
a gate to Grand Pulse.
A last gift from Bartandalus.
If we're gonna run away, now's our chance.
So, guys, which way are we going?
Back out to Eden, where we were, chapter 12. Yeah, I think that's actually the end then, yep. So yeah, this entire area is like technically optional, because that's the end of the game. Yep. Ah. Cord. watch quite a lot of Star Wars ice. Quite a few weapons needed.
Fast.
Aggression! Megrim Thresher. Oh. Oh my, ooh. Oh. She's unleashed a missile barrage and hope. Me when I'm at her house. I need you to start casting your defensive buff for cat show. This guy definitely is he hits hard enough for. I definitely want defense up more than I want attack up. I want survivability more than just killing him before he kills us. Grab this crown. And a millerite. Oh! Death resistance! One thing I'm actually willing to check quick is, because I can, the amount of CP the final bosses will be giving me. Oh. Oh, okay. Apparently, I'm getting no CP from the final confrontations. I want to just, yeah, hold as much in reserve as I can for just after the final boss. Got hit by the most. Everywhere else, I'll be coming back to like this temporary area, just kind of like these seven sacrifices and fighting them on these people. Farm travel type.
Follow my lead!
Thank you. just realized the shaman spells. So now it's an ultimate weapon that immediately got a bunch of stats. Calculator. So ultimate weapon 16. I have 382. I'll actually get me most of the way. Yeah, look at that! 110! Hmm. 30. go. Eagle Talon, 23, 2109. Particle accelerators. What are you doing on your Venus Gustle? Not premiums, but okay to sell. Stack of all three of the big ones. Those are like the most efficient. Teeny tiny bits. Venus Gospel 26. 96. There we go. Yeah, so I got to upgrade these. I need, yeah, but trapezohedron that are dropped by adamantoises. Much better weapons. Hopefully I should be able to do it. I know another thing I'll want to be doing at some point is just use up all my other miscellaneous components I only have like handfuls of and use those on accessories. Treasure, well, the other way leads to a path of more, that leads further on. Superchargers. Thank you. Come at me, bro.
Thanks.
I gotta admit, this place looks awesome.
Hit!
just enough distraction for having to cast, a lead on it. There they are! Maybe I could actually kill it faster. I have to wait for the buffs. Might as well try not waiting for them. Over and take other cap. Monster!
Come on.
Jump up, smack in the face, and then blast and punch in the face still with magic. Wow, I just noticed. Lightning has 589,666.
globe.
Launching! Demonic sphere, that should be the last weapon I can find. Yep, enfeeblement. You wanna know what that does? This makes it so she has zero attack up. Greatly reduces physical damage dealt while also giving no attack stat. This is if you want to build a purely magic one, just fang. The really interesting thing is both. Yeah, she has, yeah, both. One that's just like completely neuters her magic, but has only attack, but very high. And then the opposite, the one I just got, actually. And both of them, while technically are only slightly more powerful than a fully upgraded, Venus Gospel in its run. Or so it's basically, it's not worth it. When, like, yeah, this is just. Yeah. So, yeah. I mentioned this, but I have almost every weapon for every character. As you can see, I now have 7 weapons for every character, but every character has an 8th weapon that you can only get by buying it. And the only place to buy it is a shop I don't have access to yet. Missions. sea storm missions, one of them gives it. There's another Skeletype for mission. Yeah, like the three missions that give Genji gloves. There it is, 46 on Silent Wings in the Fault Warrens. Yeah, that gives access to the final shop, Gilgamesh Incorporated. Basically, there are three weapon shops in the game. You have Up and Arms, and this sells the general weapons. The ones that have no passives, and are, but consequently, have good stats. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, some characters have, like, two, and some have more than one. Mm-hmm. You see, like, got splits of just balanced, magic, physical, and all that. Then you have Platus' workshop. The ones here have beneficial abilities on them, but as a consequence, their stats are generally lower. And then the third shop, Gilgamesh Incorporated, has ones that have, like, the negative abilities, but also give you the highest stats. So, ones that are, like yeah, Stagger Lock. That, all Stagger Lock weapons come from Gilgamesh Incorporated. So it's a negative passive. Or yeah, stuff like yeah, Enfeeblement, or its counterpart, yeah, Stifled Magic. Those are from Gilgamesh. I think the last one is yeah, Paper Tiger, but it drops your HP. Yeah, all of these ones, they all come from Gilgamesh. So I find most of them, I still have to buy one of these. Oh my god. When I'm left for lightning, it is one of the absolute worst in general. Leaden Strike into Iron Strike, which lowers your ATB speed. It's, you pretty much have a permanent slow while this weapon is equipped. Also, Leaden Strike into Iron Strike.
I'll deal with you.
Tiger, then Paper Tiger, that's yeah, HP reduction. I like the Sog, it's honestly not that bad of a weapon point, because He already has the highest HP. He's definitely like the most okay. Again, just HP reduction, which is terrible on him because he's already super squishy. Not only is it just makes him just die super easy, but even its magical power isn't enough to match. It's just like Eagle Talon. Neil. With an Iron Strike. And Hulk. Oh yeah. Fang, it's... yeah, like... the one that, like, locked out her magic. Some people do use, because she's primarily a commando, but it also does, yep, neuter her abilities as a saboteur, and also, with your commando, you also have a good amount of ruins you use. So it's not as good as some people would like to think it is. That's not good. Get something out.
On your knees.
Definitely, Dagger Knight that was really annoying. It's that rush! It just...
got your back.
Knocked me in the air!
Practice up. Give it your best shot.
middle. I don't wanna. Stellarites are also necessary to upgrade crowns into tiaras. What's that down there? Sanctum Templar. Magic, gaze, beat the fog.
We're gonna squirm!
special.
But wait, there's more! Oh, he immediately came in! So close.
Thanks.
Star Thunder. Two of us up there, an enemy cycled into the air, beating his ass. Being that his bruise is a priority of fire. Yep. Oh, nice, got a perovskite. In case I things might not be clear, but yep, we're not going to be finishing the game tonight. Whoa, whoa. Complete as much of like the cradle as we can. Weak to all elements, but immune to magic. Resists all elements and is immune to physical. Yep.
Take down the
Jabberwocky is much more powerful than the Orphan of Enemy Castle.
Right back. Thanks.
Yeah, now. Better. Delaying the inevitable.
You're open.
Didn't even realize how it's like practically dead. Two moon bossing seeds.
Big deal. Where's this end?
There is one. I can't see it.
I can't do this. All these Seath were people once. Like us.
But that's what Bartandalus is going for. Don't you see? Make us feel guilty, lose faith, and the second we give up, it's focus time.
Wait till we're broken, and slip on the leash.
Yeah, well, when you think about it, having all this empathy, it puts us humans at a big disadvantage.
Maybe. But it's also what makes us dangerous.
Fang? What's wrong?
Oh, nothing. Just that time's running short.
It's okay. My mind's made up this time. We'll just make Cocoon our home.
Yeah. I guess we will.
I need to get past that guy. Need to get past this guy. Centurion Blade. And so, like, this takes me to another path that has a bunch of treasure on it. Effectively, my reward for meeting, the immortals. Reading glyph. adamant bangle. Oh, magic up. Yep, there's that three Scarlet Tide. And an elixir. Fully restores the party's HP and TP. This is literally the only elixir you find in the entire game. Only way to get more is to dismantle one of these doctor's codes after you've mastered it. And there's only a set number of doctor's codes in the game. So yeah, there's three of them. I'm missing one. So you have to, yeah, level it up once, so it's a star, you can dismantle it and get an extra elixir. That's all there is. Okay, so basically I get through this area and then there's one more room. Get through that. How many Scarlet Tides do I currently have? You just noticed immediately.
Take this!
Come This fight is like so annoying.
Like that.
All that work and I can't do anything!
You're up there!
I took care of all the other guys.
Thanks.
I guess not a total loss. Delta attack with diversity. Just have one where I can reach attack and heal. And not have to just bring my offense to a grinding halt. This path, I need to fight sacrifices and get Scarletites.
Thank you.
anything! I was honestly just hoping I could do that. Okay, can you please not just immediately put daze on all of us after I quake? The point of me doing this is to make the battle go faster, not for you to bring it to me grinding the halt. Forgetting I made this paradigm. Got a Scarlet Sight, so I guess I could say it was worth it. Huh? second. Like literally being I do need quite a few for a few, not just like all the weapons that need it. We have like there are certain pieces of gear that need it. Accessories, I mean. It's especially important because of it was used to upgrade a crown into a tiara. But also the thing is that crowns and tiaras, when I dismantle them, I can get Hermes sandals, or if I've already upgraded, I get that upgrade to Sprint Shoes, which is Critical Haste and Auto Haste.
Thanks.
You're gonna swerve!
Okay, next area.
Something strange about that one.
I'd strain my neck looking up at that.
Yeah, me too. Yep, 3,000 go. Oh, just... Did we just murder you? Yep.
Just
content
like that.
Charging up a powerful physical skill while also just putting on debuffs.
Thanks.
like this.
I really should change to just like tank setup as soon as I see he's locked on to lightning. Too soon. Let's try to just not get lightning EI jutsu. Target lightning, just like moving the chains.
Just like that.
It's literally just about not getting lightning gunshots. Those are random into stagger. Because okay, this guy has this, like, max. Yay. You have to max out because you need to stagger him at all. That was definitely a stroke of luck. I'm dying. Bloody trunks. I know you're not dying. Basically, I'm gonna look at, yeah, one thing quick. checking something about the Casarium. Trying to compare certain things. Yep, so in terms of just, yeah, picking up the other roles. Literally just trying to avoid getting one, I can officially equip it. Just, I guess, trying to maintain them. Dodge tank. Around 900,000. Actually, let's try to drop from the other one. A bit more with the others at around 86. So now they're all in roughly the same range, give or take. Oh, just more rematches!
Thanks.
attack of rage. Cycle around to Ozak the Bug. Make her way over to Brave and Faith.
Thanks.
I need some more shooting on you. Lightning. There we go.
Thanks.
I can't launch you into the air. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. We got this trio here. Thunders and spells, and they're not only to help reduce my damage, but they're attacked as, well, spell guards. In order to cast a spell, and leave the haste alone. Now I just need to make sure I'm under 900,000 here. Kind of high probability of evading attacks. go. Tiamat Eliminator. On the ground now. Right. Thing that I was wrestling. Oh. That might just be. Yep. Fell. That it just regularly uses the spell.
Thanks.
Thank you. 96,000. TMI Eliminator. Face.
Don't you go turning Seath on me, you hear? Not after we've come this
far. I think we should be back. Honestly, not 130. Oh, yep, this is the Narthex. Let's see if I go through here. It should take me to return to the entrance.
Thanks.
Staggered it just as I killed it.
Follow my lead.
Yeah, that's definitely a fair bit lost. Yep. Like my absolute minimum. I've used a few like for three, and I need have nine. I like the absolute minimum is 11. I think. I'm gonna just be wrapping it up here. Though probably nobody's listening because the internet's just wow, I got a delay of over 20 minutes! Because the internet's just been flicking like a light switch. Just yeah, so I'm gonna just be running around this area off camera again as just the amount of Scarlet Tights I feel satisfied with. Mm-hmm. And then next week we'll open up by defeating the final boss and truly entering the post game, which means going back to Grand Pulse and hunting down all the Seaf Stones. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's pretty much the ultimate mission's gonna be. Beat the game, work to defeat all the Seaf Stones, and just kind of go from there. I'm not going to go for like 100% completion, because that takes absorbing amounts of grinding, or just killing turtles over and over and over once you get that down pat to just get stuff to sell. That'll be then worth moolah. Mm-hmm. And you use that moolah to just buy stuff to upgrade all this. Mm-hmm. So tomorrow's a double stream, and then Monday we'll be actually doing the DLC. I'm already like at that point of Back to Origin, and I just need to get all the questy stuff out of the way, then buy the DLC. Not sure what I'll do for like Wednesday and Friday, but I'm just gonna start saying this now, is that my planned next Saturday game after going through Final Fantasy 13 is I'm gonna be going to the only one I haven't played yet, Xenoblade Chronicles X on the Wii U. Yeah, because the Wii U's like true internet death is coming, and there's Xenoblade Chronicles X is one of the games on the Wii U that really uses the online functionality, so that's gonna just... So might as well to finally get in and get started before it's gone. And then, yeah, once I get through Xenoblade Chronicles X, we'll be back to Final Fantasy 13 2. They'll play another game, and then Lightning Returns. And that's far off in the future. Till then, this has been Evander Advent. I stream every day here on Twitch starting at 6 o'clock p.m. U.S. Central Time. Today was a lucky Saturday. I managed to get to do it at 3. Not going to be so much for the future ones. Check. Because my next two Saturdays, yeah, I'm working. I might be on the 19th. I worked the same time I did today. We'll see. But yeah, join me tomorrow for the 7-day double stream. Ringu Adventure and Hatsune Miku are back to proper rhythm game Miku. Till then, everybody.